So in one of our last newsletters, we talked about how people that are new to dog training can use engagement skills in their normal life and how important it can be to put engagement on cue. In this video, we're going to talk about touch pads and how the same concept can apply to people that don't have a goal of going out and competing in a dog sport, how normal people that just want a family dog can use touch pads in their daily life. A lot of times, I'll use an example of our family. The last two puppies that Cindy has raised have been reactive puppies. And by that I mean they're puppies that are a little quick to bark at strangers or a little quick to bark at a bicycle going by or whatever. Those dogs, when they are out for a walk, need to be redirected off of whatever the distraction is that they're reactive to and redirected back onto Cindy, the handler. And we used maybe one of those dogs in the engagement video, but we have to be honest. People that are out there wanting to do competition work understand and know how important it is to engage with your dog. But the truth is, there are going to be times with a dog when it's hard to get engagement out of the dog. And that's where a touch pad can come in handy. For those that don't know what touch pad work is, and we talk about it on lots and lots of our videos, it just means that we put an item on the ground or we point an item in the environment and tell the dog to put their feet on it. Working touch pads is very, very, once the dog understands it, is very, very clear to the dog. It's something that they can understand. It's actually something, it gives them something to think about. When you say touch and you have a rock here, you know, a rock or whatever, like Cindy was out for a walk last week and there were some people coming that she thought her dog was going to be a little reactive to. She didn't have a touch pad with them, and people can carry a touch pad. We sell touch pads. She didn't have a touch pad with her. She took her sandal off and put it on the ground and told maybe to touch. It gives maybe something to think about as these people are walking by. So in this video, we're going to give you some examples of how you can use touch pads in your daily life when you need them, when you maybe can't get engagement out of a dog, or maybe you can get engagement, but you just want to do something a little bit different. So rather than engage with me and have me give you food rewards, I'm going to ask you to touch. And it becomes a game with the dog, and they end up really liking it. You see them when a dog understands it, and you're going to see that happen in this video, where Cindy will be walking along, and all of a sudden, maybe he'll jump up on a rock and offer a touch pad on her own because she likes it. So the goal here is not to teach you how to train touch pads. We have videos on that, and we're going to put them or list them at the end of this video. The goal is to show you how you can use a touch pad as a training tool or as a tool to redirect your dog when you need to redirect him off of something else in the environment. So the touch pad training, in essence, can be used maybe a little bit as the foundation for the stay command, because when we ask a dog to touch a touch pad, whatever it is, we expect him to stay on the touch pad until we release him. How can that be used? You can apply it, for example, when you go to your vet's office. What's more distracting for a dog than to go into the waiting room of a veterinary hospital and have it be three or four or five other dogs there? Take your touch pad with you, put it down, and ask your dog to touch when he's in there, and then have high value food rewards with you so that you can reward the dog for staying on the touch pad and take his mind off of all the other dogs that are in the room.